G'day tubers, welcome back. So today I've got a little bit of history on the DIY Powerwalls thing. Contrary to popular belief, I wasn't the first one to do a DIY Powerwall, neither was Jehu. Our names get thrown around a lot as the first people to do it, but the fact of the matter is there's a few people that have had them up and running before I even had mine planned. So let's get into that, shall we? First of all, the first documented Powerwall work I can find on YouTube, and I could be wrong, I mean, let's face it, YouTube's a big place. If you can find an earlier activity of someone building a DIY Powerwall, please let me know. The first one I can find is Chris Viral, link below, and I found his on the October the 5th, 2015. So he's the earliest one I can find that actually started doing a Powerwall, and his father is building it, not him. Chris has documented it and used it in several of his vlogs. And basically, he built a 40 kilowatt hour Powerwall. Now, he did build it out of 18650s and a few other chemistries, but primarily it's 18650s there. So that's the first DIY Powerwalls that I knew of that sort of existed. And then we've got me, was next on YouTube on the 17th of October 2015. And obviously that was my very first video I put out there saying I wanted to use these cells with my old PIP 2424 HS, was it? I think it was the HS. Anyway, I was upgrading. I needed something to upgrade to from my my lead acid bank back in the early days. And then, of course, we've got Jehu on about December the 25th with his $300 DIY Powerwall. Now, I know he was working on that a week or two before that video was released, so that's a vague date. But it says that I was doing my DIY Powerwall before he did his, in my mind anyway. I had it on YouTube. That must make it proper. Except I wasn't really a real YouTuber back then, and Jehu kind of was. Anyway, doesn't matter. Moving forward, I was there first. And then we've got UK DIY Powerwall, big green one. Now that was April 23rd, 2016, but I know for a fact that that was working before October the year before. So he may not have been 100% buttoned up, but it was definitely finished and definitely commissioned. Probably the second one. I do think Chris Viral's dad was the first one, but there you go, that's my take on the history of DIY Powerwalls. I definitely was the first, but I really have enjoyed being a part of it from the very early stages. If you do know of anybody that's been, like, has a documented history before then, let me know below. It'd be cool to sort of work out who was genuinely the first to do this whole process. I also like where it's heading. I love the fact that we're getting more focused on a little bit of safety. There seems to be this undertone of everything we do has got to be coming back to, is it stupid, I guess? It may not be out and out safe, but we might not be in a part of the world or the country that has that financial capability of doing it right, I guess. But some thought is going into it, and it's growing, and it's getting bigger, and it's getting done better. So I'm stoked to see where this will go. I'm stoked to see what you guys are going to come up with. I'm happy as a pig in shit with the way the forum and the Facebooks is going, with all everybody contributing and bouncing ideas off each other, and it's just growing. And now with Jehu actually finishing a project, shortly he'll have his own Powerwall running, which will be exciting to see. But anyway, tubers, that's a really simple one. A whole bunch of links below. If you like it, do that. If you don't like it, don't do that. I'll see you on the next one. Cheers!